top this evening, last evening, News Channel 5 reported the state Supreme Court had upheld a ruling from a lower court throwing out the indictment of Amanda Gutweiler-Hypes. It's a story that has a lot of people talking, and for the past 7 years, there's been a lot of interest in the case. Gutweiler-Hypes is accused of killing her three children in a Tioga house fire back in 2001. Here's News Channel 5's Mike Magnoli with tonight's continuing coverage.
So what happens next? What's the next step then for this office?
That we will present the case to a grand jury. And if they decide to return an indictment, then we'll proceed from there like you would in any other criminal case.
But you've already done this once before.
Right.
Rocky Willson and Thomas Walsh are the prosecutors from the Rapides Parish District Attorney's Office. This Supreme Court ruling, for them, means starting over again. Amanda Gutweiler-Hypes has to be reindicted now, and to put it simply, a reindictment translates to being formally reaccused, going before a grand jury. So why, after 7 years, has there been no trial? Why now is this going back to square one in the legal system? According to the ruling by the state Supreme Court, the prosecutors, Willson and Walsh, broke the rules of procedure. The prosecution allowed its two key witnesses to look at testimony from the grand jury. The witnesses were an arson specialist, Dr. DeHaan, and a Rapides Parish detective, Bobby Sandoval.
The allegation was is that we gave him something in violation of the secrecy rule in the statute.
Okay.
Now, we believe that we could do so. We believe that the language of the statute permitted us to do so.
News Channel 5 contacted Gutweiler-Hypes' defense attorney in Alexandria, Mike Small. He wasn't available for an on-camera interview, but in a statement to the media, Small announces that he believes in Ms. Gutweiler's absolute innocence, and he calls upon the prosecution to reconsider before applying for a rehearing. And to this date, the question remains, who authorized the demolition of the burnt house? How could so much potential forensic evidence be destroyed? In Alexandria, Mike Magnoli reporting, News Channel 5.